they are two groups of people on the verge of civil war in Iraq, but living in peace here in Fresno.
Sunni and Shiite Muslims in Iraq are followers of the same religion, but attack and kill each other on a daily basis in a place they call home. However, here in Fresno, they pray side by side. And as Action News anchor Nancy Osborne reports, if you listen to them, you'll have a much better understanding of the turmoil in Iraq.
Ashhadu anna Muhammad.
It is Friday at this northeast Fresno mosque, an important day of prayer for followers of Islam.
Today, we are celebrating diversity as an Islamic and American value.
Visitors, including our Action News camera, are always welcome at the Islamic Cultural Center of Fresno. But on this very same Friday in Iraq, dozens are killed in a suicide bombing attributed to violence between Sunni and Shiite Muslims.
A Shia mosque in Baghdad was attacked by terrorists.
Like other world religions, Islam has numerous sects or denominations, but here, Shiite and Sunni pray side by side. Islam was founded by a man called Muhammad in 7th century Arabia, site of Islam's most holy place, Mecca. Its followers are Muslims, who believe that Muhammad was God's last prophet and whose revelations became the Islamic holy book, the Quran. When Muhammad died, a bitter division arose over who his successors would be, who would lead the Islamic community. It resulted in two sects, the Sunni and the Shia.
There are potentially differences between the two, but those differences are not a reason to not get along and work well together. After all, we're all Muslims.
Islam has 1.2 billion followers, and while Sunnis are in the majority worldwide, in Iraq, that is not the case, with a roughly 40-60% split. This center's Iraqi-born Shiite cleric says what's happening in Iraq is not about religion. Rather, it's a violent power struggle, he says, between Iraq's Sunni minority, who supported Saddam Hussein's brutal dictatorship, and the Shiite majority, who suffered under Saddam and rose to power following his ouster.
I see it as a problem with politics.
Politics is not part of this congregation's focus. Instead, it is to be faithful to Islam and demystify it in this community. Hosting non-Muslims during Friday prayers and the lunch that follows is one way.
I like to be asked about my religion. This is the area that can affect the other part that now we are so concerned about.
We have a lot to offer and to learn.
The center's Palestinian-born executive director is also committed to that perspective.
Those are traditional clothing not to be associated with terrorism.
Whether providing cultural training for Fresno police or organizing young people for interfaith community projects in blighted neighborhoods, the idea is to become part of the fabric of America and to help their children do the same.
To have a generation that is identified and proud of their religious identity as Muslims and proud of their American identity as well.
These new Americans want the larger Valley community to know theirs is a peaceful practice of Islam.
Believing in God and be good to others.
In Fresno, Nancy Osborne, ABC 30 Action News.